Okay. Scramble intersection, which means everybody gets to run across. Oh, there's the counter for the bike path. All right. They put this thing in a couple years ago. Caused a lot of consternation, but it seems to be working okay. Anyway. And here is this new pedestrian area they've created for Government Street here. Major tourist area in Victoria. Okay. And this is the corner here, this kind of Tudorish type building with the black timbers and plaster, is probably the oldest surviving building in the city, as I've been told. As this area here, this district was one of the earliest ones built when they settled Victoria. Used to be a souvenir shop, but it's probably gone bust because of the lack of tourists, sadly, but we'll hope the building's going to be saved. Anyway, a fudge shop on the other part of it here. Yeah. So this area here used to be an old fort for Hudson Bay Company. So Fort Victoria is a couple of blocks over that way. Now it's all been redeveloped, of course. Anyway, so this is the touristy part of Victoria. The working street where they have all the banks and stuff is one block over. That's Douglas Street, but this is Government Street. Okay, I'll cross over and show this one part here. Okay, so people might have heard of a poet named Robert Service, who came to North America, and he wrote a bunch of poems about life in Northern Canada during the Gold Rush era. And it's true that he used to live on Vancouver Island. One of the things that happened was he was working up in Lake Cowichan, up island, and he made friends with an editor of the Colonist newspaper, which later became part of the Times Colonist, and he got some of his work published by the paper. So he actually had a job at one time as a bank teller in the CIBC bank, which was in this building, which is now this pub called the Barden Banker. That's where the name comes from. Anyway, so a little bit of Victoria history there, and Canadian literature as well. So I guess I should probably head home and have something to eat, because I'm kind of hungry looking at the menu here. So that's a little look at downtown Victoria. And here's the Cadillac Fairview Hudson's Bay store. Used to be Eaton's, but the Bay took it over after Eaton's collapsed. And there's a shopping mall there. And one final thing is this store here, which is a famous bookstore. Used to be owned by Alice Munro and her husband. And I believe that they separated before they got this location here, but her husband Jim ran the store for many, many years. Munro's Books, one of the best bookstores in Canada. And anyway, so this is a really famous location for people who are book fans in Victoria and around Canada. And so I can just have a quick look inside. You can see the beautiful tapestries on the walls here. Really nice, beautiful restoration work. Used to be a bank as well, you might guess from the high ceilings. Apparently the old bank vault is still in the back there. It's used to be the Royal Bank, I believe. So this used to be probably the financial district of Victoria. Well, with the Royal and the CIBC in this area. Anyway, and here we are, Murchie's coffee and tea, and you can get souvenirs for friends here who like coffee and tea, and the tobacco shop that sells Cuban cigars, which I buy for my friends who are Americans and aren't allowed to have them. And that's a little quick glance at the downtown area of Victoria, Government Street.